So, hello, my name is Piotr Dziewanowski. This is Janusz Różycki, and we are both from National Maritime Museum in Gdańsk. And we want to tell you something about the latest projects in our museum. Just for the start, in the collection of our museum, there are both items that do not exceed 1 centimeter in length, and objects measuring over 80 meters. With such diversity of objects, sizes, it is obvious that there should be used different methods of documentation relevant to their sizes. In our presentation, we want to show you two cases in which we tried to use new technology and techniques to achieve the intended objectives. On the one hand, we have the largest. This is our ship's museum, Sołdek. She was the first seagoing vessel built in post-war Poland in 1949. She was in service for 31 years, during which she took over 1,400 voyages and carried more than 3 million tons of cargo. She was withdrawn from service in 1991, and 4 years then, after 4 years, she was transferred to the National Maritime Museum and transformed into the ship museum. And with 87 meters, it is the largest object in our collection. And in 2015, as a part of the project connected with the construction of the Center for Conservation of Shipwrecks in Tczew, our museum purchased the scanner Faro Focus 3D 130. It is the scanner with the built-in camera, which scan range is between 0.6 meters and 130 meters. The device scans the range of 300 degrees vertical and 360 degrees horizontal. The same field include pictures, which are put into photomosaic. The resolution, depending on the settings, can reach up to 70 megapixels in color. After the scan is done, we have the we get the the file containing the colored panorama, which is the source of the texture, and the black and white image for the reference only. During the training on the using and operating the scanner, the appeared an idea of digitalizing Sołdek. The project assumed to the execution of scans, which could be the initial document of the object, and used to create a virtual excursion through a museum ship using software Scene Webshare. From May to September 2015, we performed 386 scans covering all the areas, even those withheld for the visitors, as well as in interior of the one of the boilers. This is the action photos, I guess. It was assumed that the large rooms can be will be performed with the minimum of two positions, and a small with the single scan. In justified cases, rooms with multiple devices or the complicated construction, the number of scans performed in each room could be increased. Since the scans were used to create a virtual excursion, we could not use the reference spheres. Therefore, in order to provide joining of individual scans, we assumed that the subsequent scans should contain from 20 to 30% of surface located in the preceding scan. And during the scan, we found out that this assumption is sometimes very difficult to provide, especially in narrow corridors and staircases connected to various decks. In that kind of regions, this coverage was less than 10%, which led us to the conclusion that the measurement error of the scanner is there up to even 7 millimeters. But as long as the these scans were considered as a preliminary documentation for the only for the excursion, we found it satisfactory. A separate problem is the noise in the areas that are covered with mirrors or bullseyes. The surface interferes with the reflection of the laser beam, resulting a decrease in accuracy of matching the individual scans up to 6 millimeters. Attempts of removal that kind of surfaces led us to the kind of things, black spots in the image, and it was not possible to proceed with that because the virtual excursion would get that kind of black spots as well. So we decided not to clean that kind of points. After the scans were processed and combined into the Faro scene, and due to the really large number of scans, they were joined in sections. Firstly, the scans made at the same day, then the sections were joined, putting the just extra image and creating a whole image of the Sołdek. And the last step was typing into the point cloud both Polish and English description of individual rooms and the vice stand board. After exporting point cloud into the program WebShare scene, we created virtual excursion containing complete information about the ship itself, devices used on board, and this excursion gives you an opportunity to measure all the selected elements. The scanning process took a total of about 86 hours, and we spent it on it, well, nearly 4 months, because we were only two. And the main problem was that the Sołdek was always open to the public, so we have to work early mornings, evenings, and even on night shifts. Development of the material in the software Faro Scene and Scene WebShare took another 150 hours. We also put 589 descriptions of technical equipment on device and board. And now, at this point, we are in the process of putting the virtual excursion on the museum servers to make it available for internet users. So this is the project about the largest item. And on the other hand, we have the smallest. And the smallest objects we dealt with, it was a collection of glass bottles with the tin caps found in the shipwreck because of them called glazed. Its archaeological symbol is F5330. It was discovered in 2013 by the employees of the Maritime Office in Gdynia during research in the Gulf of Gdańsk. The National Maritime Museum in Gdańsk was informed about the discovery, and a team of divers and underwater archaeologists made a preliminary inspection findings. The glazed is a remnant of the merchant ship from the first half of the 17th century, and it was carrying barrels filled with iron bars, lead ingots, and in addition, the wreck was armed at least with 3 guns with length of from 1.5 meters to 2 meters. But I think the most unique discovery was mentioned above, visible here, bottles of green glass with the tin caps. Divers raised more than 100 of them. They were in a very different, as you can see, different state of preservation. Some of them were preserved quite well, and others have reached far degradation. During the work done by the divers, it was noticed that the part of the tin caps were there were minted symbols, which are certainly the sign of the manufacturer. Identification of those signs would help us to narrow the dating rate of sinking the ship, and it was our aim during the project. Before describing our project and searching for the pilferers who made these tin cups. I want to say something about the bottles inside the wreck, because how did it happen that so many empty bottles found they were found on the shipwreck? To answer the question, we need to know that in Gdańsk, in the second half of the 16th century and first half of the 17th century, Gdańsk was a flourishing market for the pewters makers, and their work became a model for all the region. The number of active pewters workshops then came in Gdańsk to about 30, which is a really large number. This development is partly related with the increase of production of the glass and reduction of prices of the utility glass in the second half of the 16th century. Local production bottles were put together with the tin cups manufactured in Gdańsk and exported in large number by the Gdańsk merchants as a ready-to-go product. So far we had only evidence in the written sources to this export, and now we have physical evidence as well. Above, I mentioned that the part of the bottle caps have had producer signs on them. These marks can be divided into two categories. First, by far dominant group are the crowned roses, which you can see on the left, first and the second. Appearing in two versions, the smaller and bigger. The second, far less numerous, are the marks with the double coat of arms. On the left of coat of arms, you can see the sign of Gdańsk, the crown and the two crosses, which it is a visible proof that the producer was from Gdańsk. On the right, there is a house mark of manufacturer. And let us first see the second group. They were preserved in the state that makes difficult a proper reading of the marks. At the beginning, we tried to scan it well with faro arm, but it was no use because they were too small. The double coat of arms is about 60 millimeters tall, so faro arms wasn't good. So we decided to use the RTI method. Here we can see the same cup in a RTI viewer. The technique is quite simple. You take the dozens of pictures with the camera with a flashlight, and that allows you to create the 3D image, which is, well, a fake 3D image. It's very good for poorly preserved objects. And this is the result of the RTI, and this is the drawing. This sign has been identified as a house mark of the Salomon Gisseler. He was pewterer in Gdańsk. He became a master in pewterer's guild in 1655, and he was the author of two tin sarcophagus of Anna, the daughter of Duke of Szczecin, Bogusław XIII, and her son, Ernest, Duke of Croy. He done this work in 1661 and 1684. And he was, he came from really known at the time family of pewterers who were in Gdańsk from 1532. And from this family came another tin sarcophagus. It was This is the house mark of Salomon Gisseler found in those sarcophagus. So it led us to conclusion that this is the same person as on the tin cups for the bottles. And this family made another tin sarcophagus. It was sarcophagus of King Stefan Batory in 1587. So. It means a lot because this family was very known in the region of Poland. Even though they were known at that time, we don't know very many information about the Salomon Gisseler. We know he was active master in the guild from 1655 till 1684. Another producer sign occurring on the bottles was examined with RTI as well. And it is this sign. It is very poorly preserved, but on the left you can see the coat of arms of Gdańsk. After the, well, maybe it's not the best shot taken, but still you can see the right, on the right, the house mark and P and S, the initials. And we didn't have any clue about the master who's owned this house mark, but we found on the lists of the Gdańsk masters in the guild, Pelterus masters, that there was only one man whose initials were PS. It was Paul Shedlock, who came who became a master in the year 1657. So it is by far only mention about him. But according to those informations brought to us by RTI, we can locate the sinking of the ship somewhere between 1657 and 1684. But still, we hope that next year the divers will come and get us some more information. A separate larger group of marks, as I said before, are crown roses with five petals. And you can see here on one of the marks, there is S and G initials. And it is very tempting to say that they have connection with Salomon Gisler as well. But on the, as you can see on the bigger roses, we made RTI as well here, you can see very, very little, because it's about 1 millimeter tall, date, 1635, which doesn't really suit us with the image of Salomon Gisler, who became a master craftsman in 1655. Often that kind of marks were connected with the becoming a master, the date of becoming a master, of the, or the sign of changing the law by the guild of pelterers. But for now, we do not know for sure what is that date, and because of that, and I must say, speak now as an advocatus diaboli in our own case, that we really don't know. Maybe next year, when we will find some new evidence or new evidence in the archive, we will know what that date means, because it would change the datation, this raw datation of the sinking of the ship. So thank you very much.